pushes Alice too far while TK's future is on the line in Shortland Street.
Buses, hoardings, billboards.
Sounds expensive.
Well, you got to spend it to make it.
I like the plan. It's solid. But it's way out of our league.
What have you done?
I assumed that he would sign off on stages 2 and 3, so I put them into production last week. And I spent the money.
How much?
All of it.
I'm sorry, can I call you back?
Sophie, enough. You and your brother are already bleeding us dry. How many times do I have to say no? I'm sorry, but... she hung up on me.
Only time she'll turn rabid when you come between her and a fashion item.
A pair of ridiculously priced heels.
That'll be her trying daddy. Cowan.
Care to tell me what you're up to until the wee hours? I have no idea what time you finally came to bed.
I'll be sure to wake you next time. Any preference how?
I'd rather sleep, thanks. Although with you it is possible to do both.
If you can call ecstatic thrashing about sleeping.
Sad that after all these years the concept of faking it still lives.
Morning.
Hi, boss.
Chris.
Callum, up close and personal.
Sorry?
As opposed to a digital billboard or every bus within a 10K radius.
What one has to do to drum up some business.
How much must one pay? I look forward to your cost-benefit analysis at the end of the month.
A treat in store. What?
Awesome creative accounting keeping you up late, was it? To pay for the publicity?
I don't know what you're talking
about. Save it, Callum. Stop praying you can pull the wool over Chris's eyes. You don't? I will be the first to put the boot in.
Come on. You must have worked out how Mackay operates. He's just out to keep you on the back foot. No way is he going to fire you.
Can I have that in writing?
You had 48 hours to shape up or ship out. Now, that deadline is long gone.
Yeah, but he still hasn't given me the nod either way.
Yeah, thus keeping you on the back foot. That's pretty much bullying, just like I did to you. And what do we do to bullies?
Tell the teacher.
No. You let the bully know that you know what he's trying to do and that you're not going to let him get away with it.
Tell him to rack off?
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll work. Yeah, he's pushy, but he's good.
Well, so are you. Way too good to have to just sit at his feet. He just wants an audience.
Yeah, well, I'll do whatever to get him to sign off on my GP training scheme application.
You're way too easy.
Lucky for you, eh?
Hey.
What?
Okay, get his signature and then tell him to rack off.
Dr. Samuels, Dr. Potts.
Callum.
Ready for a day of listen and learn?
You bet.
Now, today's focus, thorough but efficient gathering of information for quicker diagnoses and building relationships with people so they come back to us again and again.
Sounds great.
Trainer wheels securely fastened?
Whatever.
Okay, let's go.
Morning, just finishing today's to-do list.
I'd like all Callum's promotional paperwork on my desk, ASAP.
Okay, but first we need to go through today's end-of-day deadline.
And contact our business manager and source all PCC expenditure to date right away. Thank you.
Absolutely.
He will need a regional lymph node dissection, and I have organised one for tomorrow.
More surgery, poor love.
And then a referral to an oncologist for more treatment.
Is that chemotherapy?
Yes. But for how long, we won't know until after the operation.
Right. Thank you, Doctor. The family's worried sick, as you can imagine.
Of course. And I will talk to Keith again before the operation, make sure that he knows exactly what's going on.
Thank you. He'd really appreciate it. Oh, hello, love.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Oh, that poor boy Keith out. Well, it's not looking all
right. Why are you discussing him with his doctor? It's totally illegal.
Well, she doesn't seem to mind.
Because she thinks
thinks you're a relative.
I've just been there for them. They're country folk. They're completely bamboozled by the hospital system. I'm just trying to help them
deal with... Stop it. Just stop. You're a hairdresser, not a medical professional.
I know that, but the poor boy is so sick.
Listen to me. Stop taking over. Baxter's already complained to me about
Baxter.
You.
Baxter? He just needed a good firm kick up the backside.
No, he doesn't. He's a nurse here. You're not. So just dress here and do nails and stay out of the way. A patient's treatment has absolutely nothing to do with you. Got it?
Fine. But first I'll just update poor Keith and his family. They're worried sick.
Okay, Ron, now what can we do for you today, sir?
I need a new script for my cholesterol medication.
All right. Mm-hmm. Okay, your last reading was 4.5, which is very good. Medication's obviously working.
Yeah. I want to change, though. I've been on the internet, and there's this new drug. Here's the name.
All right.
75% effective, and the one I'm on now is only 50%.
Yes, you're right. But I'm glad you're paying for it and not me.
Well, why?
Well, it's not subsidised, so you'd have to pay the full slog.
Oh, hang on. No one's anything about that.
Not on the net. No, they don't.
No. Oh, the other one will do then. Like you say, it's working.
I think that would be best. All right, there you go. Stay on the medication, keep on the diet, and you will keep going and going.
Is that it?
Is there something else?
No, no.
Good. Bye.
Take care, mate.
Cheers. Thanks.
All over in 2 minutes.
Impressive.
Most consults should be like that. TK, find the problem, sort it, move it on.
Save time for the really tricky cases.
15-minute max per consult still applies. Saving time means we can have more throughput.
Ching, ching.
Always remembering, no ching, ching, no job, job. Callum Mackay. Yes, Miss Jeffries, what can I do for you? All right, I'll be right there. You're on your own.
Chris wants to see me.
Cool. Okay. So, find the problem, sort it.
In under 15, move on.
I don't believe it. The student becomes the teacher.
Hey.
Congratulations. You managed to spend an entire year's promotional budget in 2 weeks. Bravo.
Look about.
I'm curious, when I said hold off on spending, what did you hear?
I'd already spent it.
You'd already spent it. Without the customary consultation when it comes to major sums. And now this. Cooking the books to cover your tracks. Poorly, I might add.
Look, I can explain.
Tell me again, who was it that mismanaged the last place you worked at? The one where you learned so much about how not to run a clinic?
I'd prefer to say calculated risk, not mismanagement.
I prefer breach of contract and instant dismissal. Care to comment?
My campaign is hard...
I'm sorry, Libby wasn't there.
A few moments, please, Justine.
Sure.
You were saying?
Chris, it isn't about the money spent. The question is the campaign effective? Are we getting bang for buck? And the answer is yes.
No, the question is, do I sack you?
Look, and Chris, if not... Chris, if this clinic isn't up to speed by the end of the month, thereby paying for the publicity, you won't have to sack me. I will quit.